China is set to send its troops to Russia for joint military drills. The exercises will take place from August 30 to September 5, with other countries taking part, including India and Belarus. Beijing's defense ministry, however, says its participation is unrelated to the current international and regional situation. China just launched fresh military drills around Taiwan following recent visits of U.S. lawmakers. Russia, on the other hand, is waging an invasion in Ukraine. National Security Advisor Clarita Carlos visits Pag-asa Island in the West Philippine Sea. The Armed Forces of the Philippines says she was escorted by police and the Coast Guard. The local government unit of Calayan Island also posted a photo of Carlos's visit online. The island is part of the Calayan Group of Islands, which is being claimed by China. This despite an arbitration court ruling in 2016 that favors the Philippines. China, however, continues to be aggressive and previously protested visits of ranking Philippine officials in the island. President Marcos inclined to extend the state of public health emergency in the Philippines until the end of the year. The state of public health emergency was declared back in March 2020 during the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic. It allows government to intensify its response and enforce quarantine and disease control measures. It also allows for the emergency authorization of COVID vaccines.
Maraming mga binibigay sa international medical community kapag state of emergency, WHO is one of them. At kung itigil natin yung state of emergency, matitigil yun. But if we can change, we are looking at amending the law in terms of procurement and all of that in the middle of an emergency. But that will take time. So malamang, we will extend it. We will extend it until the end of the year.
Marcos made that statement after he received his second booster jab during a vaccination drive in Manila on Wednesday in the hopes of encouraging more people to get their fourth dose.
Now, I was just told by Yusek Verhere, mukha namang meron ng ilalabas na vaccine para ito, para dito sa mga bagong variant ng Omicron. Kaya at pag-aaralan natin, and if it is going to be helpful, gagawin natin ang lahat para madala rito sa Pilipinas, para mabigay natin sa lahat ng kailangan magkaroon ng booster shot.
Latest data from the Health Department shows 72.1 million Filipinos have already completed their primary doses of COVID-19 vaccines. Of that number, only over 17 million have received their first booster shot and 1.8 million their second booster.
Senator Grace Poe joins a list of Philippine lawmakers who've been infected by the coronavirus. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri confirmed Poe tested positive for COVID. She is the fourth senator to contract the virus after Senators Alan Peter Cayetano, Sin De Villar, and the president's sister, Aimee Marcos. Due to the infections, the Senate implemented on Monday a three-week lockdown, barring guests from the building. An infectious diseases expert urges the Philippine government to require teachers to get fully vaccinated against COVID. Dr. Ronjin Solante says teachers will play a crucial role in building a wall of immunity in schools, which will open for in-person classes next Monday. Solante also believes minors should already be given the booster shots.
Nakikita natin ngayon with this BA5, medyo marami-rami rin ang mga bata na infect, no? Although mas marami pa rin ang adult, pero hindi nagiging konti ang mga na-infect na mga bata, especially the less than 11 or 12 years old, no? So, ibig sabihin, if you want to level off in terms of lahat protektado in a population, then kasama dapat yan, hindi lang yung 18 years old and above sa booster, but also the adolescent. And hopefully, we can also plan for the booster also for the 5 to 11 years old. So that wall of immunity against any variant, especially for Omicron, mamanatili sa population.